Hey there, Sharon Hornell from here, poking buttons while the video starts. Welcome to day 2242 of What You Up To Now. I see my nephews when they were little in suits, both in suits. Must have been a Christmas picture. So today we're talking about judgment and spiritual growth in the Let's Grow Annual Challenge. So talked about judgment, and a lot of people think of judgment as a bad thing, but ever since my sudden cardiac arrest in 2010, I have used it as a trigger or a light switch to flip the way I'm thinking and looking at it. For some reason, when I woke up from the coma and freezing after my cardiac arrest, which is part of why I'm still here today, I'm very, very grateful for that, I realized, and for some reason, judgment, whenever I heard it from other people or whenever it was spinning around in my head, it really, really bothered me, which I think is probably one of my lessons during my coma, that I needed to face up to that and to be yourself. Be you, be you, be you, be you. Be true to who you are as you're growing and developing, and especially with respect to spiritual development. So those two messages came through loud and clear to me, and I try to act on them. Of course, it's been 14 years, so I kind of ebb and flow whether I am strongly following them or not, just like anything else, right? We focus on things for a while, and then we get interested in other things because we've learned what we need to learn about that. But I definitely have not learned everything I need to learn about judgment or being myself. So topics for other days, which I'm sure we will discuss and talk about. But I've actually trained myself now to, when I catch myself being super duper judgmental, not always with my self-talk, that's a continually improving journey, but with other things, like if I am commenting on something or joining in on a conversation and I'm getting judgy, all of a sudden it flips the switch in me and I say, okay, who am I to judge this? Why am I sharing my opinion on this? Unless I'm asked for my opinion on it, unless I'm talking in my videos because they're my platform, I don't just offer up my thoughts, feelings, judgments, or opinions on things because it's none of anybody's business, right? Especially when it comes to highly emotional topics like religion, politics, the state of the world. Well, I do comment on the state of the world pretty often, but so we're talking about judgment and using it as a tool for growth, spiritual growth and personal growth in other areas and aspects of our life. I'm sure we will discuss it further this year as part of the challenge, but specifically with respect to our spiritual growth and development and our connection to a higher power, right? Higher power, meaning whatever it is to you, God, the universe, Jesus, I don't know, I'm watching, The Chosen right now with my mom, and so and then Jonathan and Jesus. Great series. If you believe in Jesus, or even if you don't, it's a great series to watch and learn a little bit more about the Bible. I think they've done an excellent job in portraying the stories and the lives of the apostles. It's the story of Jesus mostly through the experiences and the eyes of the apostles, and I think it's an excellent presentation. And my youngest sister says it helps her remember all the apostles or disciples, whatever you call them, names now. And she didn't realize how handsome they are. She'll be mad I said that. So talking about judgment and, you know, where is there more judgment than in religion and politics? I don't know, probably, which is why maybe those topics I don't choose to participate in very much unless asked or unless something trips me and triggers me, just like all of us, because it feels like such a grave injustice and it feels so, so wrong. So judgment, very, very interesting topic. It's another one of those, like all of the spiritual growth topics that are so personal to us. You know, our spiritual growth is all about us and us becoming a better version of ourselves, us becoming the entity, the person, having the experiences we want to have while we're here on earth. So talk about that. And then for Supersize Your Business, we discussed one of my current favorite topics right now. For some reason, my son and I are really, really curious about mergers and acquisitions. And so I talked about strategic acquisitions today. And I've been on both sides of that, both acquiring businesses strategically for my company or for companies that I work at, as well as being acquired as part of corporate America. I was in, and some of my businesses have been acquired as well. Being on both sides of that coin gives me kind of an interesting perspective in terms of what's important and what we sometimes overlook and forget, but we sure better remember because it can come back to bite us in the booty if we don't pay attention to it. I am having a travel day today, heading home after a pretty extended trip with my mom. She's having some health challenges. And so my sisters and I are taking turns coming down and spending time with her and making sure that she's okay. And she does what she needs to do and gets where she needs to go. Except blind me cannot drive. So I'm not as helpful as the rest, but I can cook and I can help and I can encourage her. So that's gotta be my part in the equation these days. If I can help you in any way, hit me up and ask. I'm going to be sitting in airports today. So that will be fun. Always is entertaining to watch people and probably be reading or something and doing my own thing, which I like to do too. Sometimes you just want downtime where you can just be yourself and be in existence and be present and experience what's going on around you. And I haven't really done much traveling in the last few years. All right. If I can help you in any way, please, please, please ask. Otherwise, I will, of course, be with you tomorrow. Have a fantastic day.